Hey everybody, welcome back. I have no clue what happened there. Apparently, the broadcast just failed or something. So what I did was I quit the game, and I'm basically going to restart it over so that we don't have two broadcasts separated, because the first one was only 15 minutes. It'd be one thing if, it was like halfway through the game. I'd probably just pause the game and restart from there, but so early in the game, I don't think so. But what this also allows us to do is check out, some of the scores from earlier in the day. Kings defeat Warriors, which is, I'm actually shocked by that. Timberwolves defeat the Grizzlies. Heat beat the Wizards. Celtics take their first win over the Nets. Bucks defeat Hornets. Pistons over Nuggets. Pacers over 76ers. The Lakers are the first team to hit 2-0. They defeat the Suns in their second game. Trailblazers defeat the Thunder. And that's it. There are two games after the Raptors and Hawks game, and we will see those later. So let's dive right back into this game. Same rosters, same everything. It's gonna be a good one. Hopefully everyone enjoys it, and hopefully it doesn't stop on us again. That'd be nice. Magic Johnson, James Harden, Scottie Pippen. That is a heck of a team for the Raptors. Larkin, Garnett, and Gasol are the top players on the Hawks. From what I saw, it was looking like it was a good game before it cut out. A very close game. So we'll see if that holds up to be true again this time around. Hopefully.
Brought to you by Sprite. It's the 2K Sports pregame show.
Hello again, everybody. I'm Ernie Johnson, along with Shaquille O'Neal on 2K Sports, and the NBA season is about to begin. Tonight, it'll be the Atlanta Hawks going up against the Toronto Raptors. For Toronto, they come into the opening game of this season with the goal of getting that first win out of the way as soon as possible. How they'd love to be sitting at 1-0 by the end of this evening. Boy, the Hawks have some big bodies along that front line, Shaq. How do you keep them from dominating the paint?
Well, you have to collapse down. You got to show double. You got to be real aggressive, especially on your rotations. You can't let them get too deep inside on you, Ernie.
Truer words never spoken. Let's turn it over to Kevin Harlan.
Been waiting for this day for a long time. It's opening day in the NBA. Thanks everyone for joining us here in the start of a new season. Along with Steve Kerr and Clark Kellogg, this is Kevin Harlan. It'll be the Raptors off the tip. Looking at the starting five for the Atlanta Hawks. Dandridge is out there with Garnett. And there's Terry, and it's Marc Gasol, and it's Larkin in at the point.
We always like to get that first lead of the game.
Yeah, you know, Steve, a good way to set the tone early on there. You know, the issue really with Atlanta this year and moving forward isn't that they're a bad team. They've just been kind of stuck in that middle road of mediocrity. They're competitive, play hard. They're hoping to find a way to get to the next level now.
The Hawks shooting their first free throw tonight.
About a year ago, they converted about 78% of their free throws as a team, so pretty solid there.
You know, Kevin, they would love to post a similar percentage again this season. I mean, I think that's safe to say they'd love to shoot free throws as well as they did a year ago.
Now here's Johnson. It's blocked. Gasol with it. Scottie Pippen grabs the miss. And Harden wide open. He shoots. The shot's good on the assist by Pippen. Harden's got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game. And now Doris Burke has an update from the sidelines.
I was able to talk with Mike Budenholzer for just a moment. This is their first matchup of the season against the squad, and he knows the shot blocking in the middle will certainly be an obstacle. But he said, quote, "We've got to remain aggressive and continue to attack." Guys, he said that putting their bigs in high pick and rolls and shooting the open jumper with confidence will be key. We'll see how they do.
Thanks for that report, Doris. Guys, do you think we'll see game planning early on that might end up developing through the game as, you know, as far as getting through this very tough defense?
I think there's almost no question that what they're doing offensively at the beginning of the game will change several times before we're finished.
Well, that's what the defense they're facing forces you to do. You have to be ready to adjust and make some changes. It's too complex a defensive scheme to just attack it one set way.
For Toronto, they've gone 2-3 here to start out the game. Johnson left side. And good. Got the friendly bounce off the right side of the rim. Johnson's got his first points of the game. For Atlanta, they've gone 3-4 from the field to start out the game. Garnett with a screen on Johnson. The feed to Garnett to the left side wing. Here's Larkin. He's guarded by Johnson. Six to shoot. The three. Nice shot by Larkin. Larkin's got his first 3 points of the game.
How in the world did they let him get that wide open?
And here's Toronto. They trail by three. Johnson, the pass to Dawkins. Terry against Harden. Johnson dishes to Lewis. Dawkins kicks to Johnson. To the middle, Kevin Garnett with the steal. Last break here. Here come the Hawks. Here's Terry. It's hauled in by the Raptors.
The defense was ready for him that time, and they had to be. He is so powerful in the lane.
And Gasol sends it back. Here's Larkin. Stolen by Harden. And here's Pippen. Up to the stripe. Jump shot is good that time.
And they have to mix it up defensively. That was just too easy.
Hawks have gotten 4 of 6 field goal attempts to drop in the first quarter. Gasol a screen on Johnson. Gasol a screen. Larkin the pass to Gasol. Got freed up. Nice work off the pick. Gasol's got 6.
Very well executed pick to give him all kinds of space to get that one off.
Johnson, the pass to Dawkins. And good coming off the assist by Magic Johnson.
Yeah, no mistakes on the offensive execution there.
For Atlanta, they've gone 5 of 7 today so far. Nice shooting to get this game underway. Here's Larkin. Pass to Terry. Looks for Garnett. He gets it to him. Soft touch off the glass.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
Yeah, that's 5 of their last 6 baskets inside the lane. They have really established themselves inside. Well, Kevin Garnett came into this league straight out of high school, initially a 6'9 small forward, but he continued to grow and enlisted at 6'11 for most of his career. For whatever reason, he's never embraced actually being called a seven-footer.
And Garnett, every bit 7 feet tall. And in his prime, one of the most mobile and agile seven-footers the league has ever seen.
Yeah, and one of the best jump-shooting seven-footers from that 15 to 18-foot range as well. Led the league in rebounds per game four consecutive seasons from 03 to 07. Looks like one of those guys that was made to play the game.
Off on that one, so he goes 1 for 2 at the line.
Well, hockey rules supreme here in Canada, but you got to respect these diehard Raptor fans. Even through the losing years, they've shown their support.
Here's Larkin. 6 on the shot clock. It's going to be 2 free throws. Drew contact on the shot. And the hockey season runs pretty much concurrent to the NBA's, Clark. I think hoop fans in Canada in the past sometimes looked at as eccentrics.
Well, that could be, but the sport is growing, and not only in size, but in popularity. I mean, we've seen some terrific prospects coming out of Canada. If the Raptors can craft a contender, you better believe those folks will be making that arena a madhouse.
And the first one drops.
You have to give the Hawks a lot of credit for what they did last season. They knew they were going to lose some players and have to hit the reset button and recalibrate a bit, but they did so quite smoothly.
Larkin hits them both. Well, for the Hawks, it's been 2 years of big names like Joe Johnson and Josh Smith leaving. Steve, they still remain competitive.
Well, they always seem to have a backup plan in place for whenever a star player leaves. And yeah, really, this has been the plan all along, the foresight to create space and picks and cap room. They're trying to build something special here. And, of course, it takes time.
Now, here is Harden. High shot from 10 feet out. Harden's got 5.
Boy, he can be a matchup nightmare inside the paint.
The Hawks leading. Here's Larkin. He's got 5. Feeds it to Garnett. Into Marc Gasol. It's hauled in by Pippen.
That's his comfort zone, so defensively, really nice job challenging the shot.
Dawkins kicks to Johnson. Outside Pippen, in the corner, Harden. A second chance effort, and it's good on the layup. Dawkins has got his 3rd basket of the night right there.
Giving them an opportunity at second chance points with some hard work on the glass there.
Garnett dishes to Larkin. Back to Garnett. Terry against Harden, and it's Terry off the drive, offline with the baseline jumper.
Can't get a much better look than that, though.
Sure can't. Not one you'd expect him to miss there.
Lewis passes to Harden. Here's Larkin. Gasol trying to free himself up. Good D by Johnson. The Raptors have gotten 7 of their first 10 attempts to fall so far. Excellent pace to their offense. Here's Harden on the wing. And unable there to get the go-ahead bucket. For Atlanta, they've gotten 6 of 11 shots to go down so far. Pretty nice shooting. Down low. Stolen. Oh, and here comes Johnson all alone. The big dunk at the end of the break.
The defense to start and ignite that play was terrific. And I love the fact that they attacked early in the shot clock.
And now that they have the lead, they might even want to get more aggressive defensively. Really attack, try to come up with more steals.
And Atlanta calls their first timeout of the game. This, of course, their first chance to take a look at this year's Toronto squad.
This game kicks off what should be an interesting season series between these clubs. And, of course, they'll see each other 4 times this year.
Brad Doherty, he's checked in for Toronto. Tomic, he's checked in for Atlanta. Here's Larkin. 5 points in the game. Pass to Terry. Out left of the wing. Larkin kicks to Terry. Dandridge. And he's good on the 3 ball. Well, as Steve was saying, Clark, you know, they're in the same conference. There's going to be a lot of familiarity there. And who knows, after that, they may see each other in the playoffs, too, if all goes right for them.
Well, that's certainly a possibility, Kevin, but we've got a long way to go before that scenario comes to pass.
That's right.
Well, those chances are almost always 2 points for him. I guess the defense did what it had to do to bother him.
Garnett with a screen on Johnson. Larkin, the pass to Tomic.
And a chance to see where James Harden ended up in the rankings last season. Fifth in scoring, ninth in free throw percentage. And he also finished in the top 20 in assists. So this is a guy who really did a nice job of sharing the ball with his teammates.
And Steve, he was definitely one of the most reliable, efficient scorers in the NBA. I mean, his top five ranking put him right there in the ranks of the elite scorers.
First one falls for him.
Toronto, Canada, the home for the NBA All-Star Game next season. And we know how global the NBA is. A lot of excitement and anticipation here in the T-Dot for a celebration of basketball.
Here's what Toronto's going with right now. Chris Middleton's checked in for Lewis. Collins comes in for James Harden. And Smith subbed in for Johnson. Raptors trail by three. Here's Collins. Collins, a screen on Garnett. Smith dishes to Middleton. Toronto working the ball around now. And that one's good. And Toronto, guys, not necessarily viewed as a free agent destination in the NBA. But, Steve, it's a diverse city with a lot to offer.
And not least of which, Kevin, a vibrant nightlife, which I know you have enjoyed on occasion. But look, the Raptors, you know, they have a terrific home record, particularly on Sunday matinee games. A lot of speculation that visiting players maybe were out a little bit too late the night before. Who knows? Maybe
Steve,
you even ran into
Steve,
them.
Steve, where are you getting this stuff from, man? You
Thanks,
are
Clark.
Reaching.
Clark and I are watching
about.
Tape is what we're doing.
That's
we're
exactly
tape.
What we're doing.
Getting ready for the broadcast.
Enjoying the four walls of the hotel room.
Pippen can't hit.
Well, he had to fade away there. The defense was all over him, and he got it off. Just couldn't get it to go.
Hill kicks to Scott. They set the pick. Six to shoot. Deep two from Hill. Again, the Hawks score.
Boy, has there been any defense played yet in this game?
Nope. This game has been all about rapid-fire offense early.
Kicks it to Doherty. The 11-footer. Rebound, Atlanta. Outside, Scott. Hill inside, guarded by Pippen. And the basket by Hill. And it's a 7-point Atlanta lead.
Very positive opening quarter for them. The shots have been falling.
You know, the shooting percentage would be nice if it stayed right there, but that's going to be tough to do.
Took advantage of some shoddy defense there. They've got to at least get a finger on it.
Hill left side. It's taken away by Smith. Middleton the pass to Smith. Right wing. Doherty the screen. Hill against Smith. Now here's Ariza. Quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game. Outside Hill. Dishes to Scott. In Atlanta again with the bucket.
Easy little jump shot for him right there, guys.
So, timeout called here, the first for Toronto.
Kevin Garnett was the fifth pick back in 1995. He's had a long, illustrious Hall of Fame career. He was the league MVP back in 2004.
A minute 20 left in the first quarter. Doherty with a screen on Hill. Smith dishes to Doherty. Back to Smith. Doherty, the screen. Smith kicks to Doherty. Six on the shot clock. Back to Smith. Here's Collins. Sinks it. What range from outside. Wow. Collins has got himself going there. His first points of the game on the deep ball. Outside Hill. Scott against Collins. Garnett with a screen on Collins. Ariza goes in. A little shot fake there. Got the D out of position. And the Hawks lead by six.
Boy, they are just destroying them in the paint.
You could say that again, Steve. The defenders just aren't aggressive enough down low.
Doherty with a screen on Hill. Now the pass to Collins. Back to Smith. Here's Collins. Takes the 13-footer, and he knocks down the jumper. Collins has got his second bucket of the night. Now Hill. Garnett with the screen for Hill. To the inside. Here's Tomic, and he comes off the screen and slams it through.
One of the oldest plays in basketball made that dunk possible.
That's right. A terrific screen right there, Steve, allowed him to lose his man and rock it to the rim.
Well, don't you love to see players working together in that fundamental play? Fun to watch.
The offense coming free and easy as we wrap up the first quarter. Hawks ahead. They lead by six. And the second quarter about to get started. We'll be back in just a moment.
For a scary night of basketball, Halloween in the NBA. The Los Angeles Clippers take on Dwight Howard and the Los Angeles Lakers this Friday, 10:30 p.m. Eastern, 7:30 Pacific.
And now the second quarter just getting set to start. And what do you guys think about the Hawks here in this one?
Just the start they wanted to this game. Solid offense. They got good ball movement. Established a nice rhythm.
Yeah, not stagnant at all. Free-flowing and fluid at the offensive end.
By six. On the court for Atlanta, they've got Marc Gasol. Tomic is out there with Trevor Ariza, and it's Green, and it's Scott in at the one spot. Green kicks to Tomic in Atlanta again with the bucket.
They've had assists now on their last three baskets.
And it's not just their passing, but their cutting, their movement together as a unit that's led to that.
Johnson goes in. And the layup's good off the glass. Johnson's got six.
It is so hard to contain him. He just seems to get it done however he has to do it.
Making the playoffs was a goal the Raptors had been working towards for a long time. And last year they were able to get back to the postseason for the first time since 2008.
Johnson against Scott. Shot clock at 6. The Hawks need to get off a shot here. That's good. Domic has got the lead up to 8 now for the Hawks.
Superb assist there. He played the role of the maestro on that one.
Long drought came to a close last year, Clark, for Toronto. It wasn't a long ride in the playoffs, but the Raptors sure provided some excitement.
Well, that game 7 loss to the Nets, Kevin, broke some hearts, but that's just a young team losing to a veteran team, and that always serves you well when you're looking to become more competitive, and ultimately the Raptors benefit from that type of experience.
Back to Scott. Fires from deep. It's hauled in by the Raptors. Lewis has got his third rebound tonight. Now let's send it to Doris from the sideline.
Well, Kevin, the Atlanta Hawks, a team that looks to spread the floor with shooting. Coach Mike Budenholzer said, we don't want to just be a three-point shooting team. We want to get to the rim first. By creating that space, we give our guards and our bigs a chance to attack. If the paint is taken away, we'll look for our shooters. Good strategy, Kevin.
Coach Bud coming from San Antonio, Doris. The Hawks trying to create that same kind of spacing. Johnson, the pass to Collins. Back to Johnson. Doherty with a screen on Green. Doherty dishes to Johnson. And again, it's Toronto converting.
They've been getting it inside at every opportunity and getting results, too.
It's a great formula, and it's really a sign that the offense is clicking.
Johnson against Scott. Pass to Gasol. Fader on the way, and he gets it to go. Gasol's got 8.
Man, great ball movement. They're just picking this defense apart with their passing.
Well, how about the 3P's, Steve? Purposeful, precise, passing. We love it, and so does this team because they're taking advantage of it.
And the basket by Johnson.
8 of the last 10 points at that end of the court have been scored on very high percentage shots in the paint.
And it's not necessarily strategic, Clark. It's just a matter of playing with more heart. Got to play hard, guys.
Ariza outside. The dish to Scott. Outside, Green. Ariza kicks to Green. There's the triple. That drops. Green's got himself on the board with 3 there. And almost 4 minutes gone here in the second quarter of play. Collins passes to Johnson. Doherty inside. Missed inside.
Great defense in the paint there, making it tough on the offense.
That's what he brings, a presence. I mean, you saw it on that miss.
Here's Collins. He's got 5, and it's blocked by Gasol. And the officials whistle a foul on the shot. The bucket's good. He'll go to the line. That's going to send Brad Doherty to the line. They get Marc Gasol. Hey, guys, what do you think about the offensive approach we've seen so far for Atlanta?
You know what, guys? It looks to me like they're really in sync here, all on the same page. They've already got a bunch of assists.
And the fact that they're playing well, close to the hoop, finding points in the paint, I mean, they've got it all going tonight.
That one falls for Doherty. Now the Hawks were in a bit of transition last year, that phase of their development. But one area that they really struggled was getting wins on the road.
And that's always hard to do. They were very average away from home this season, right in the middle of the playoff pack.
And with Atlanta on the road, they didn't really play too terribly, but they just didn't close out games away from home when they needed to.
You know, winning on the road is often about the little things, and that's where Atlanta came up a bit short last year and why they ended up with only 14 road wins, the lowest of any playoff team in the East.
Johnson kicks to Lewis. Lewis, right side, Harden outside, and that's out of bounds. Toronto will retain possession.
Nice play to get a hand on that pass and tip it out of bounds.
I tell you what, guys, if he gets there a fraction earlier, that's a steal.
Just 5 to shoot. shoots from the elbow, and it comes off the front of the rim. The Hawks leading by five. Larkin dishes to Green. He kicks it to Terry. Trying to find Green. He's got it now. And he drops in the layup off the glass. Green's got 5 points now this quarter.
He had his head on the swivel and was able to pick out the pass and get the assist.
Harden against Terry. Passes it to Dawkins. Got a piece of it. And that's out of bounds. Toronto will retain possession.
All right, a chance to check out the stats for James Harden. Terrific year last season for him. Averaged about 25 points a game, 6 assists, and 4 rebounds. And it's no secret he can score. He was number one on his team last year in scoring.
And his teammates know that when they need a bucket, they look right at him.
Achevon, 6 of 8 from the field in the second quarter. Here's Larkin. He's got 5. Pass to Dandridge. High post try. And it's wide right. Hits off the rim.
What was the defense doing there? I mean, he is not the guy to give an open look to, and yet they got away with it.
Doherty the pass to Lewis. Johnson kicks to Harden. Some nice ball movement here by the Raptors. He feeds it to Doherty. No luck. Good D by Gasol.
You know, he just hasn't looked right to me. A bit out of sorts, if you will. Something's off with his mechanics, at least as I look at it.
Larkin dishes to Green. Another 3 for Atlanta.
You know, one aspect of their play today that's really been tight and far superior is their passing.
Agreed. I mean, you look at the points, I mean, they're getting a lot of baskets off of assists, so the offense really clicking here.
And the Raptors call time here.
New front office starting last season for the Toronto Raptors, and it seemed the roster of the team was going to be subject to some changes as well, as the team shed some of the big money players who hadn't been able to lead this squad to many wins in the past, and now they're looking to a promising future.
Kevin Garnett has checked in for Gerald Green.
Man, he has been their unquestioned leader offensively this quarter.
The Hawks leading by 6. Here's Larkin. Now the pass to Dandridge. The 3 ball. The offensive rebound. Gasol. Harden right side. Here's Johnson. It's good. The assist that time from Harden. And now it's just a 4-point Hawks lead.
Well, you know, he has shot the ball well, but it has not been contagious. I mean, his teammates, they haven't had the same groove, and that's why we're looking at this result so far. They tried to step in and cut him off, but just not quick enough.
And we have the benefit of replay, but I think they got that one right, which is the case most times, even though fans don't think so.
The Raptors making a switch here. Pippen's checked in. Dandridge. Nice spin off the left rim and in. Dandridge has got 5 points now in the quarter.
The pick wasn't ultra effective, but it got him just enough room for the score.
Johnson kicks to Lewis. Here's Dawkins. Excellent D there from Garnett. The Hawks leading by 6. Here's Larkin. He's got 5. Garnett kicks to Larkin. That's Dandridge. 5 on the clock. Larkin can't get it to go. Toronto's shooting has been beyond great up until now. How about 57% from the field overall? Here's Pippen. And it's off the back rim. No good.
Well, that's a very low percentage shot. Not good basketball at all. One he probably should have passed on.
2 open that time. Made it look too easy. Dandridge has got 11 points.
Heads up play there, guys, on the assist and the finish.
Johnson kicks to Pippen. Gasol with the steal. Pippen against Dandridge. Here's Larkin. Garnett with a screen on Harden. Here's Gasol. And he can't extend the lead to double digits. And it's Johnson penetrating. Uses the glass to finish the layup. Johnson's got 20.
He's been a bright spot for them. He's had an incredibly efficient offensive performance.
Steve, his shooting really has been just terrific. They'd be much worse off if it weren't for him, that's for sure.
And they're on the break. Here's Harden. The shot's good on the assist by Pippen. And now it's only a 5-point Atlanta lead.
That's how you make it happen, guys. Ball pressure and then a run-out.
And those are the kind of plays that will turn that deficit into a lead quickly. So solid defense on the ball, that's the key.
Atlanta calls timeout.
You know, the Hawks haven't been an elite team, but they do have the longest active playoff streak in the East. They've been the 7 straight postseasons. And while they haven't advanced very far, I still think there's something to be said for getting to the postseason 7 years in a row.
Here's what Toronto's going with right now. Chris Middleton comes in for Rashard Lewis. And Smith subbed in for James Harden. Harden kicks to Garnett from 13, and he gets the bucket. And for the Hawks, with that playoff streak, for a team, Steve, that has missed the playoffs in the 8 seasons prior, that's something to be proud of.
Yeah, I mean, Atlanta has shown consistent winning basketball now over the last, you know, 6-7 years. They've shed some of their marquee players, suffered some big injuries, but they've still found a way to remain competitive.
The Hawks leading by 5. Doris Burke has some information for us. Doris?
Yes, guys. Mike Budenholzer had some words for his team. He'd like them to concentrate on their transition game to keep the tempo fast and put pressure on the defense in the open court. He also wants them to concentrate on working as a team at the offensive end. Passing, patience, and teamwork. Those were the messages. They're not going to wait for halftime. They want those adjustments to have an impact right away. Over to you, Kevin.
All right, Doris, thanks. Terry, the pass to Garnett. 1:57 left in the first half of basketball. Back to Terry. Clock at 6. The shot is off. And Toronto will go the other way with it. When this game is done, they'll be off to Orlando and they'll take on the Magic. That'll be the first half of a 2-game trip.
And for the Magic, you know, that's a game they would really like to take.
Pippen, no luck.
Boy, just by his body language, Kevin, you can tell he thought that triple was going to fall.
Yeah, a little frustrated now, shaking his head after that miss.
Here's Larkin, covered by Smith. Gasol dishes to Larkin. Let's it go from 14. And yes, sir, that one drops. Larkin's got 7.
Tell you what, it's a huge plus to have him making shots like that.
Clark, they've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a little bit of cottonmouth here. Dry spell for sure.
Another good pass, and their offensive execution has been impressive.
Here's Larkin. Kicks to Terry. Three-pointer. That's good. Terry's got six in the quarter.
Oh, he's going to keep banging those home if you give him that much space.
Toronto calls timeout.
Looks like he saw some things out there that needed adjusting and wants to talk it over a little bit with his club.
I don't think you can ever go wrong burning the timeout if you see something you don't like and you need to talk about.
Well, let's take a look at last year's top scorers. Fifth on the list, James Harden.
Well, anytime you can be one of the best scorers in the league, that's special company and something you should be proud of. It's not easy to do on a consistent basis to be amongst the scoring leaders.
Raptors trail by seven. Johnson outside. They double-team Johnson. Dawkins, the pass to Johnson. Here's Dawkins. The shot misses. Good D by Gasol. Terry outside. Dishes it to Larkin. Now Terry. He's got nine. The pass to Andridge. Shot clock at six. Floats one. A nice shot by Gasol. Gasol's got the lead up to nine now for the Hawks.
Beautiful feed off the bounce to his teammate there. Nicely done.
Here's Johnson. Good work defensively by Gasol.
Great defense in the paint there, making it tough on the offense.
That's what he brings, a presence. I mean, you saw it on that miss.
Pass to Andridge. Left side, Terry. There's the dish to Garnett. And so he draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot two.
The Raptors have not defended well against Garnett.
He has 8 points and a steal.
For Atlanta, they have made the most out of their opportunities at the line. They have yet to miss in seven attempts. And the first one drops. Brad Doherty, he's checked in for the Raptors. Both free throws good from Kevin Garnett.
Well, guys, maybe the most important play in the NBA that isn't really tracked at all is the screen. A good one can make a huge difference in creating a high percentage shot, but it's a play that so often goes overlooked.
He had his choice of finishing moves there, and you just gotta love the fact he went old school with the finger roll.
Here's Larkin. He's got seven. He kicks to Gasol. He feeds it to Terry. From the line, a rebound by Johnson.
They've been able to get out to this lead without really getting a very reliable performance out of him from the field. Yeah, he got whacked. Shouldn't be much debate on that one.
Yeah, that was as straightforward as it gets, guys.
And guys, what do you think about the offensive approach we've seen so far for the Hawks?
Well, the great passing we saw in the first half has carried right over into the second.
They've worked hard to get the ball into the low post tonight as well, and it's paid off.
First free throw is good. That one falls, so he hits both of them.
Looking at the game Pippen has been having, he's got 8 points, and he's come up with a couple of nice steals today, too.
Well, he's been playing a very energetic brand of defense, Clark. You got to love it.
They get it again. Gasol. And that one is good with the extra effort on the glass. Gasol's got six in the quarter. Raptors trail by nine. And keeping us updated from the sideline, let's swing it over to Doris Burt for an update. Hi, Doris.
Well, Kevin, for some, Aaron Gordon is seen as a tweener. And for Gordon, it isn't going to faze him. He said, obviously, you have to play a position in the NBA, but I'm going to do a little bit of everything. Post up, hit jumpers, go by people. I'm going to do it all. I'm confident that I can play both the three and the four. He has the skills to pull it off, Kevin.
And he does. Thank you, Doris. And taken away by Magic. And here comes Harden, leading the fast break.
Easy call there. No question about that one. You could hear the impact from where I am.
It's his first trip to the line.
And you look back at last season, he shot 87% from the foul line.
Yeah, that's a great asset to have, guys. For any team coming down the stretch in close games, you've got a guy who's confident and very good at the line. When he steps up there, you feel good about it.
Gerald Green, he's checked in for Atlanta. And both free throws good for James Harden.
You know, even though they're down, they are putting on a show at the free throw line this half.
I think they've done a good job of making the most of their chances at the line, and they've got to keep it up to take the lead.
Gasol, a screen on Harden. Dandridge. Again, the Hawks, good for two.
You look at the Hawks and how they were able to overachieve last season. Really, it's because they've built a smart basketball team that really understands how to move the ball.
Fade away, count it, and the Atlanta lead has been cut down to four again on the bucket from Johnson. Hawks have gone 7 of 11, a lucky field goal percentage here in the third. Larkin kicks to Gasol. Passes Dandridge. And he uses the glass on the layup. Dandridge has got 15 points. Well, Clark, you see it here with the Hawks and their passing. Saw it all last year, too, as they were elite when it came to getting baskets off of good team passing.
Yeah, and I think that's Mike Budenholzer's carryover from being part of the San Antonio Spurs organization. It's all about everybody contributing, understanding your roles, and sharing the baskets. That can be effective when you're talented and have good shooting.
And the Hawks making a change here. Tomic has checked in. Here's Pippen. Atlanta with the rebound.
Boy, there was no hand in his face right there. I thought for sure he was going to knock that down.
Larkin kicks to Tomic. He dishes it to Green. Here's Larkin. He's guarded by Johnson. Just 5 to shoot. Pass to Dandridge. The 3. No good. Nice D from Pippen. Raptors trail by 6. The feed to Harden. Back to Johnson. It's Harden with the drive. That's good. Harden's got 15 points.
You know, when he's in that tight with that kind of height advantage over the defender, that's going to be a pretty easy play for him.
Here's Larkin. 7 points in the game. Here's Garnett, and the Hawks getting another basket right there. In Toronto, they've gone 8 of 13 on shot attempts to begin the second half. And it's Johnson penetrating. He can fly, can he? He'll make you forget he's a point guard sometimes.
Yeah, Clark. When he does decide to attack the basket, Kevin, he can do it with the best of them.
And this is the time to attack with these two teams locked in such a close game.
Garnett buries it from about 10 feet away. Garnett's got 8 points here in this quarter.
This is some kind of performance we're seeing from him today. He has yet to miss a shot.
It's Harden with the drive, and again it's Toronto converting.
He has been fantastic this quarter, guys. It's just the kind of lead if they're going to continue.
Larkin feeds it to Larkin. Dishes to Green. Nice ball movement here by Atlanta. Dandridge passes to Green. Four on the clock.
He thought that triple was going to fall.
Yeah, a little frustrated now, shaking his head after that miss.
Outside, Lewis. That's in there, Johnson with the assist. Johnson's got his seventh assist here tonight.
Boy, when you've got a big man who can shoot from distance like he can, what a huge bonus that is.
Here's Larkin. He's got seven. Kicks to Garnett. From 13. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here. He's gone 2 for 2 at the line so far. A free throw good from Kevin Garnett.
Look at the free throw percentage. Unblemished since halftime, Clark. That's pretty nice.
I'd go farther than that, Steve. How about perfect?
Catching up on the changes for Toronto. Chris Middleton's checked in for Lewis. Collins comes in for James Harden. And Smith subbed in for Johnson. Atlanta also making some changes here. Trevor Ariza's checked in for Tomic. Scott comes in for Dandridge. And it's Hill in for Larkin.
Boy, I tell you what, he does not look like your typical big man up there at the line. He has an excellent stroke and a percentage to match.
Here's Doherty. Byron Scott pulls it in.
Obviously, they're evenly matched teams on the inside. The rebound numbers are very even.
Yeah, I've been impressed with just both teams' energy, just really working hard on the boards.
Garnett kicks to Scott. Back to Garnett. Can't hit, and Toronto will come the other way. Three, Pippen can't get it to go.
Almost surprised that he had that much room to work with.
And it's Ariza in the corner. Outside Hill. And the wide open shot from Green. But they get it back. Ariza kicks to Hill. On the wing, Green. Green left side. Here's Ariza. A three-pointer off the mark. Raptors trail by three. Trevor Ariza last season with perhaps the best campaign, Steve, of his 10-year career.
Yeah, he played starters, minutes, shot a career-high three-point percentage. I think a lot of it, Kevin, was just the combination of playing with good bigs and then also John Wall's emergence as a great point guard. Ariza had a lot of open looks last year.
The turnaround jumper. Count it. Doherty's got 7 points.
You know, the turnaround jumper, guys, is one of those shots that always just looks so good. I mean, it's got that nice, smooth, singular motion. Sweet.
Hill dishes to Scott. Good, and it's Hill picking up the assist. Scott's got his second basket of the night.
And you could say that Ariza was in a contract year looking for a new contract, playing for a new contract, but he's upped his three-point percentage for three straight seasons. It seems he's put in the work to really solidify that part of his game.
Garnett with the block. That one's in there. The Hawks lead is cut down to just one on the basket from Doherty. 35 seconds left here in the third quarter.
And Ariza has always been great shooting threes from the corners, but he's diversified a bit. Last season, the highest total of three-point makes in his career.
And Green gets it to go.
Now you got to like his shot selection today. He set a good example for the rest of his teammates.
Pippen with it. He's got 11. There's the pass to Doherty. Shoots from the baseline. Good. Doherty's got 11 points.
Smart. Use that big height advantage. Get the shot off.
Well, it's hard to put a big man on him, Steve, that far from the hoop. I mean, he's versatile.
And Hill has it in the corner. 1 second left. And the release was before the buzzer, but it's off target. We're at the end of the third, and we've still got a close one. Hawks ahead. They're up by one. And right after this, we'll bring you the start of the final quarter right here on 2K Sports.
It's a Halloween broadcast of the NBA. LeBron James and the Cleveland Cavaliers go up against the Chicago Bulls this Friday, 7 p.m. Central. Don't miss it.
And a quick look now at the State Farm assist of the game.
Really excellent feed here, and I know we're used to seeing this guy score, but he is no slouch at creating passes and opportunities for his teammates, and he showcases that skill right here on that replay.
Here's Pippen. All right, now a chance to set the floor courtesy of Gatorade. Fourth quarter action, all fueled up and ready to go. On the court for Atlanta, Marc Gasol is out there with Garnett. Then it's George Hill. Then it's Trevor Ariza. And it's Scott in at the two guard. And here is Hill. Pass to Garnett. Let it go with a three. The rebound by Pippen. Pippen's got his third rebound tonight. Smith outside. The dish to Pippen. Dawkins a screen on Ariza. So they take the lead. Pippen's got the fourth quarter going with the first basket of the period here for Toronto. The Hawks trailing. Outside Hill. Outside Scott. Hill passes to Scott. Just five on the clock. It's hauled in by the Raptors. Dawkins has got six rebounds in the game. Smith outside. Pass to Dawkins. Fades back. And there are the Raptors with another bucket.
You know, from that in-between range, they've actually been the much hotter team.
Well, when you make perimeter shots and knock down those jumpers, it opens up everything else.
And it's Hill penetrating. That one goes. Count.
What's going on defensively there? A lack of focus, no concentration. Too easy.
Toronto's gotten fewer than half of their three-pointers to go down tonight. They're 4 for 9. Pippen kicks to Doherty. Played in with a nice touch off the glass. Doherty's got the lead up to 3 now for Toronto.
We're seeing him bring that shooting percentage up now, guys. The first half was a struggle for him.
Garnett with the screen for Hill. He kicks it to Garnett. It's back to Hill. Shoots the three. That one goes. Count it. Hill's got it all tied up now for the Hawks.
That's demoralizing. They needed a stop there, and instead, they give up 3 points on an open look.
For three, Smith. That is good.
How about the response? Retaliation. Impressive, huh, guys?
I'll say exactly that as well. Nice job to recover those 3 points right away.
Atlanta calls timeout. And with a fourth quarter push coming up here, the coach going over the game plan and these players rehydrating themselves with Gatorade, recharging their bodies, refocusing their minds, and getting that strategy down to close out the game. And some changes here for the Raptors. Lewis checked in for Doherty. Harden comes in for Collins. And it's Johnson in for Smith. And then for Atlanta, Dandridge, he's checked in for Ariza. Terry comes in for Byron Scott, and Shane Larkin subbed in for George Hill. Let's catch up with Doris from the sideline.
Hi, guys. I had a chance to find out what Mike Budenholzer was discussing with his guys. He told them, the game is right there for the taking, fellas, but we've got to be first. First to loose balls, first to the rim. We have to give our all right here. Kevin, now's the time.
Terry against Harden. And again, Toronto with the triple.
That's his first three-pointer of the half. Remember, he did make one in the first half as well.
Well, if you're just tuning in, welcome. We've got about 3.5 minutes gone here in the fourth quarter. Here's Larkin. He feeds it to Terry. An amazing finish with a hand right in his face.
It hasn't happened as quickly as he would have liked, but he's finally putting some points on the board in this game.
Harden kicks to Johnson. Johnson right side. And another basket for Toronto.
You know, tired legs can affect you at the defensive end, and I think that's what's happening right here.
I agree, because as much offense as we saw early, we're seeing even more of it here late.
Larkin kicks to Gasol. Good.
They're getting on a roll inside. Their last three field goals have come from inside the paint area.
The defense has to make an adjustment. They've got to string together some stops, or at the very least, try to force this team into some bad shots.
Oh, a nice defensive play to disrupt the alley-oop. On the wing, Terry. He's guarded by Johnson. Terry kicks to Larkin. Back to Terry. Shot clock at 6. And it's all evened up. Terry's got 10 points here in the second half.
This is a fantastic performance in this half. He didn't play as well in the first, but you just know with this guy, he's always ready to turn it around.
Here's Johnson. Atlanta with the rebound. Larkin's got 4 rebounds now tonight. In low to Garnett. And Atlanta again with the bucket.
He always knows where his teammate's going to be, and Kevin, that will let him put the ball where he wants it, right waiting for him.
Toronto calls timeout. And look at Kevin Garnett. What a contribution.
And he's getting to the rack all game, and if they can't do a better job of keeping him out of the paint, they're in for a long night.
Against Garnett. Here's Dawkins. Here's Johnson. Lays it up and in on the nice reverse. Johnson's got it all tied up now for the Raptors. Atlanta's gone 1-2 from three-point range here in the fourth. Here's Larkin. Garnett with a screen on Johnson. Here's Larkin. He's guarded by Johnson. Larkin can't get it to go. Raptors have gotten 7 of their 8 shots to fall here in the fourth. A tremendous offensive outburst. Harden against Terry. Harden gets the bucket. Harden's got 5 points in the quarter.
You know, it's really going to be all about hard work from this point on. And they worked hard to create that high-quality shot right there.
Yeah, and that's their goal down the stretch. Continue to find those close-range shots.
And he gets the bucket.
How about the field goal percentage shooting this half, guys? It's gone through the roof.
Toronto, they've gone on a tear here in the fourth. They're 8 of 9 on field goal attempts in the quarter. There's the triple. But they'll get another chance. Here's Pippen. And again, it's Toronto converting.
This game has been very close in a lot of areas, but rebounding is one thing that they've been able to dominate.
Yeah, they've chased down that pumpkin often.
Garnett with a screen on Johnson. Larkin dishes to Garnett. Pass to Larkin. Just 5 to shoot. Releases from 15. The shot is off. Now Toronto takes it the other way. Now here's Johnson, inside, out of bounds. Atlanta will take possession.
Boy, did they ever make a mess out of that one. A terrible turnover.
Atlanta's gotten the three-point shot off 16 times tonight. 7 times they've hit it, 9 times they've missed. Good-looking screen by Gasol. Larkin, the pass to Gasol. He dishes it to Larkin. Back to Gasol. 6 on the shot clock. The fader. Second shot opportunity, and it's good on the way in.
Love the way he fought for that putback. You know, he's willing to put in a lot of hard work in this game, no doubt about that.
Harden outside. The feed to Johnson. Pippen for three, and good coming off the assist by Magic Johnson. Johnson's got assist number 8 here in this one already. Gasol, a screen on Johnson. Harkin kicks to Gasol. Over to the left wing. Dandridge. Another three for Atlanta.
Yeah, and that's his first three of the half. There may be more in store.
Toronto's gone 3 of 4 from downtown here in the fourth. Now here's Johnson. Defense is right there. And he gets contact and the whistle on the shot. 2 shots coming up. That one falls for Dawkins. And both free throws good for Dawkins. Atlanta's gone 2 of 3 in the fourth quarter from long range. Good shooting so far. Here's Larkin. Feeds it to Gasol. Larkin dishes to Terry. Dandridge passes to Terry. Shot clock at 6. Dandridge's shot is good. Dandridge has got the game tied up here for Atlanta.
Nice, accurate pass right into the middle.
Harden against Terry. Harden kicks to Pippen. Back to Harden. Dishes it to Johnson. Good. It's Harden with the assist that time. Harden's got 3 assists in the game. Here's Larkin. Kicks to Garnett. From about 16, again the Hawks score.
Really good execution there, guys. They saw the mismatch and they went right at it.
Timely bucket. Couldn't have been a better opportunity.
Inside. And Dawkins slams it in.
You can see the eye contact there. Gave a little nod and then burst to the rim for the alley-oop slam.
No doubt, Clark. Their teammates with a terrific feel for each other out on the floor.
And what a play to make in a close game. A potential momentum builder.
Here's Gasol, and again it's Atlanta.
The defense starting to falter. I think we're seeing some tired legs there, Clark.
Toronto calls timeout. Left in the fourth quarter of this one. To the inside. Gasol with the steal. Dandridge in Atlanta again with the bucket.
They're earning their points with the jump shot now.
Yeah, that's 6 of their last 10 points coming in that in-between range.
Harden kicks to Johnson. To the inside. Deflects the pass. Dawkins. And the basket good. Dawkins has got 23.
Excellent execution of the plan there.
Atlanta calls timeout. You gotta like what Magic Johnson has done in this game.
He just continues to light them up. They're gonna have to find a way to make him work harder for his point.
Third. 1 left in the game. Garnett with a screen on Johnson. Larkin, the pass to Andrews. There's the dish to Gasol.
We've watched Gasol play great basketball. He has 20 points, and the steals are starting to pile up for him also.
They sure have. And clearly, he's gotten in their heads because of it, Clark. The guys are looking over their shoulder now, always worrying about where he is.
First of two, no good. Heartbreaker. Second of two is good. That gives them the lead.
Now, one more make would have been awfully nice, but I'm sure they're happy just to take the lead.
Johnson attacking. Again, Toronto.
He has really punished these defenders today. No matter who's been on him, he's been giving them medicine.
Atlanta's gone 2-3 in the fourth quarter from long range. Good shooting so far. Garnett, the screen. 3 left to play in the final quarter. Larkin dishes to Garnett. Stolen by Lewis. Fast break, Toronto. Here's Johnson. It's good!
He's coming up big right now for this team in the fourth quarter. He's now 5-for-6 shooting.
Atlanta with the ball. Garnett with a screen on Johnson. Dawkins against Gasol. The shot is off. Now Toronto takes it the other way. Well, we can probably expect to see him slow it down now.
Yeah, you got the lead. Burn some clock here.
Smart move.
Yep.
And for the Hawks, they're shooting 61% from the field. Showing some marvelous touch out there. Garnett with a screen on Johnson. Right wing. Dandridge. Sinks it. And oh, that was an enormous three-pointer.
Huge points. That's beyond huge, Steve. I mean, they needed that bucket desperately.
And the Raptors call time here. The score is knotted at 125. 11 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. Johnson, the pass to Dawkins. And Harden wide open. He shoots. Misses the three. Regulation is ended and we're heading to overtime. We'll be back shortly live from the Air Canada Center in downtown Toronto. Well, if you love great competition and neck-to-neck basketball action, this one has been a great one. Overtime number one, getting going right now. It'll be the Raptors off the tip. So the overtime period is now ticking away. Should be fun. All fueled up and ready to go to overtime basketball here, brought to us by Gatorade. Let's check out who's on the floor. So for Toronto right now, we've got Harden. Doherty is out there with Lewis. Then it's Magic Johnson. And it's Pippen in at the small forward. Here's Larkin. Garnett with a screen on Johnson. Garnett, the screen. Here's Larkin. He's guarded by Johnson. Just 5 on the clock. Here's Garnett. And there's 2 points. Working on the glass, paying off that time. Garnett's got the first basket here in overtime for the Hawks. Toronto trailing. Here's Harden. And he gets it to go.
That makes it 10 of their last 12 points coming from inside the painted area.
Yep, that's something that the defense has to put a stop to. Maybe a defensive adjustment is necessary here.
Overtime still getting started here, just about a minute in. Larkin kicks to Gasol. From from 11 feet away, and the shot is good. Gasol's got 23.
Ah, the turnaround jumper. That was a thing of beauty.
Toronto's gotten a positive outcome on 7 of their 14 three-pointers in this game. Not bad at all. Johnson attacking. Off the left rim and out.
Boy, there was no hand in his face right there. I thought for sure he was going to knock that down.
Looking to get it going. And out of bounds as Toronto gains possession.
Well, that's inexcusable to throw a pass that far off the mark.
And Toronto has possession. A two-point game. Harden dishes to Doherty. Harden the pass to Doherty. And Gasol sends it back. Terry in the corner. Nice ball movement here by Atlanta. And the pass to Garnett. Played in with a nice touch off the glass. Garnett's got 4 points in the quarter.
Not much the defense can do once he gets to the bucket.
Toronto, they've gone 1-3 from the floor since the start of overtime. Doherty, the screen. Johnson kicks to Doherty. Lewis dishes to Johnson.
Shooting for Toronto, Magic Johnson. 2 shots.
And that one misses. And he sinks the second. Just under 2.5 minutes passed here in this overtime. Atlanta calls timeout. Burke has some information for us, Doris.
Yes, guys. Mike Budenholzer had some words for his team. He made sure that everyone was on the same page and that the offense needed to run through Garnett. Coach asked him directly to take the reins of their offense. He wants him to have a huge impact at that end of the floor for the rest of this game. The second thing he said to them was that they should be looking for opportunities to push the ball up the court and convert some quick, easy baskets in transition. Those are adjustments that could have a big impact at what is a critical point in this overtime, Kevin.
And thank you for that, Doris. And it's Terry off the drive. And 2 free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there. It's going to be on James Harden.
Easy call there.
No question about that one. You could hear the impact from where I am. Take a look at what Jason Terry's done. He's got 13 points and 4 assists.
He's making such good decisions with his passing and also being aggressive and getting to the line by drawing fouls.
Well, that's an excellent combo to have, I'll tell you that.
Both shots good from the stripe.
In a crucial spot, he is always so solid at the line. He rarely wastes those opportunities.
And the Raptors call time here. Johnson outside. Pass to Pippen. He kicks to Doherty. They get a hand on it. Jacks up a three. And again, Toronto no up.
Boy, just by his body language, Kevin, you can tell he thought that triple was going to fall.
Yeah, a little frustrated now, shaking his head after that miss.
Doris Burke has an update for us. Doris?
Yes, guys, I was able to hear Dwayne Casey coaching his team during that break. He made no mistake that their plan was to run their offense through Johnson. Coach detailed the ways to ensure he's the one in charge out there, with the ball in his hands and the rest of the players falling in line behind him. Those are changes that coach must feel very strongly about if he's willing to make them now, here in overtime, Kevin.
Thanks, Doris. First free throw is good, and that increases their lead to 6. Free throws here. So now it's a 7-point game.
Showing off a very smooth stroke at the free throw line right there.
Toronto's got neither of their first 2 3-point attempts to fall here in overtime. Passes to Harden. Looks for Doherty and gets it to him. Puts it up from 12, and that one's good. We're now over 3.5 minutes through this overtime period. Pass to Dandridge. In low to Garnett. Gasol trying to free himself up. And the shot is good from Garnett. Garnett's got 8 points in the quarter.
They've built this lead through plays exactly like that. He's easily been their most consistent performer.
Well, he's been splashing everything today.
Fades and shoots. Doherty with the bucket.
Intelligent passing there to make that hoop possible.
The Hawks leading by 5. Here's Larkin. Garnett up top. Lots of room. In Atlanta again with the bucket.
I don't think they can ask much more of him than what he's done this quarter.
Raptors have gone a shade under 50% for the floor here in overtime. They've hit 3 of 7. Hawks have gotten things started superbly in overtime, hitting 5 of their first 7 shots. Garnett with a screen on Johnson. The feed to Garnett. To the left wing. Shard Lewis pulls it in. They can score it here, but it won't mean much.
No, not at all. Not a real chance of getting back in it at this point.
Yeah. Steve, you think it's over?
No, it's over. This lead is just too much for them to deal with.
Doherty, no luck.
Now, he was right there, but the defensive pressure forced that miss.
Well contested. That really made it a tough shot.
Here's Larkin. And so it's Atlanta with the W. You know, Clark, they couldn't put him away in regulation, but after a superb performance in overtime, they managed to get the job done.
Yeah, just an amazing game, but they pulled away at the end.
And now let's catch up with Doris Burke, who's standing by on the sideline. Doris?
Well, Mark, congratulations on this win. What was the key to getting the rhythm going for the team's offense?
Shooting the ball, you know, just making the play, just, you know, making each other better. That's always something really good in that. It gets contagious both sides.
Mark, thank you for the time. Guys, this is a heck of a big man.
All right, Doris, thank you. And for Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for tuning in to the NBA on 2K Sports. Now, our Jordan player of the game, Kevin Garnett.